Has anybody had a recent job interview? Just out of curiosity. Both of you? Okay. Is it okay if I ask you, I don't want to put you on the spot, but can I ask you like kind of how it was? Do you feel like it went well?
Yeah.
Yeah. Did you get the job?
Yeah.
Oh, cool. Nice. So yeah, we're going to talk about like what to do to get the job. You know, what do you need to do to prepare? How do you need to be ready for it? That kind of thing. So I'm going to show you a little PowerPoint, but we can also talk as we go along. And I have some sample interview questions for you too to give you that you can practice, like you can prepare and be ready for an interview. Finding a fit for what your skills and strengths are with a company and showing them that you're a good fit is a big part of interviewing. And so preparing for an interview, Rebecca mentioned this, but like knowing the company that you're going to go talk to, so reading their website, looking at information about the department that you're going to work at. I also think it's a good idea, if you can, to go to the company and walk around before the interview, like, you know where it is. Before I interviewed at Cascadia, I came in and found Kodiak Corner and walked around and just kind of got a feel for, okay, this is where I'm going to come for my interview. And that helped ease my anxiety because I knew where it was, I knew what the people might be like, that kind of thing. And then practicing. So practicing is a huge part of doing well in interviews, preparing for the questions that they might ask. Oftentimes when people feel like they didn't do well in an interview, it's when you feel like you didn't know how to respond at all to a question that they asked. So the more you can practice and be prepared, the more confident you're going to feel when you do it. And so I'm going to give you some sample questions, but there's on the internet, there's tons of like samples about interviewing. You could just type in sample interview questions and you would get a lot of them. And there's different types of interviews, too. There's like phone interview, there's in-person interviews. Sometimes there's a panel of people interviewing you. There's also behavioral interviews where they want to know, you know, how would you respond in this particular situation? So they're looking at more like your reaction to certain things rather than just what you know. And so, a big thing I think about doing well in interviews is knowing your accomplishments. And what do you think of when I say the word accomplishment? Like what comes to mind?
Degrees or certifications.
Degrees and certifications. Good. Anything else?
Experience.
Yeah. Great. So it can be good before an interview to make a list of all of your accomplishments, like your degrees, your experience, things that you've done well, and have that in mind. And because oftentimes they ask you, you know, tell me about your experience, or tell me about a situation where you did well at this particular job, that kind of thing. So you want to have stories in mind. You want to have them fresh on your mind so that you're not, you know, freeze when they ask you certain questions. And another way to think about accomplishments is things in your life that you feel like you've done well, you've enjoyed doing, and you're proud of. And so it's a way to kind of think about what some of your strengths are. So throughout your life, what things in your life have you done well, enjoyed doing, and you're proud of? And that can give you information about what some of your strengths are of announcements and being able to have them in mind can be really helpful. And then it's helpful to go back through your accomplishment list and think about, you know, which one of these made a good story? Like, which one could I elaborate on if they asked me what my strengths were? And looking for strengths that show up, like, regularly. Like, are you perseverant? Are you a good communicator? Are you able to multitask? Are you punctual? So what are some just basic strengths that you have? And then you also need to know, you know, what skills you have that match the job description as well. So what, like, technical skills you have, what can you tell them that you can do? And then you have to be able to sell it. So you have to practice talking about yourself. Because that can be hard for some people, because in the interview you have to sit there and tell them, you know, how good you are. And that can be a challenge sometimes. So practicing with someone, having them ask you questions and then responding to them can be a good way to ease that anxiety about talking about yourself. And then these are just some basic things, but before an interview, plan out what you're going to wear. Like, you know, what do you want to wear at the interview, getting that ready. And like Rebecca was talking about, knowing the culture of the company. Like, is it going to be a formal interview? Are you going to be able to dress more casually? Because some companies have different ways of dressing. And there's also, I won't go into this too much, but there's also something about what colors you choose, too, that says something about you. Colors like black, dark blue, gray, those kinds of things tend to look more professional at times. And you don't want to have like big patterns on your clothes, I've heard, because if you have smaller patterns like checkers or stripes, it makes you look more detail oriented and kind of more like you're able to take care of smaller details rather than the big patterns. I'm not an expert on that, but I heard someone talking about it and I thought it was really fascinating to think about even like what color you might wear to an interview and how that might affect how they perceive you.
It distracts the interviewer. So
right.
Like, what I read about too is bright colors.
I could get like bright orange on.
Yeah, they start thinking about your clothes instead of you.
You want them to focus on you and see that you're the good fit, not focus on your clothes. And then be prepared having like a notebook, a pen, copies of your resume, references, like having everything with you in case they ask for it. Like they may want another copy of your resume, they may ask for your references. You may, like I had an interview recently actually, and they gave me about 10 minutes before they started the interview, and they gave me the questions ahead of time. And I said, this is what we're gonna ask you, you have 10 minutes to review the questions. And so I sat there and I had my pen and paper and I was like taking notes and thinking about what I was gonna say to the questions. And so being prepared with those kind of things can be helpful. Maybe also bringing some water. Like if you started, if they don't provide water, you know, if you started choking, like having yourself prepared for whatever might happen is helpful. And then the day of the interview, you want to make sure you know where you're going and get there on time. And so planning to leave a little bit early. Make sure that you eat before the interview so that you're not thinking about what you're going to have for lunch. You know, so you want to focus on the interview. And I mean, a lot of us drink coffee, like we were talking about that earlier, and that's fine, but you're probably already going to be stressed that day, so don't like overload yourself with caffeine and things that are going to make it worse for you during the interview. And then being confident, so shaking their hand, and what do you think like a good handshake would be like? So if someone has like kind of a limp hand, that's probably, what do you think that says about them to the interview?
Not confident.
Yeah, I mean, just go ahead.
What happens if the interviewer has like a limp handshake?
Yeah, that's tricky.
That's always hard.
Yeah. I would still try to have a firm one, like on your end. You know, you can only control what you do.
Right.
And even sometimes in interviews, your interviewer might not be a very good interviewer. And so you kind of have to deal with the fact that they aren't asking you good questions, you know, that they seem really nervous. Because they're just people too. So you just have to try to present yourself in spite of that. But on your end, you didn't think that much. Oh, okay, sorry. But having a firm handshake, having good eye contact, trying to be yourself. Somebody told me that one time they were going into an interview and they tripped and almost fell, like if they were walking into the interviewing room. And that could be pretty devastating, you know, if you're trying to have it all together and that kind of thing. But she said that she just started laughing and she's like, well, sometimes I can be a little bit clumsy, and kind of played it off pretty well. And the interviewers laughed a little bit too, and it kind of built some rapport between them. And so she took like a challenging situation and turned it around. So if something happens that, you know, could be embarrassing, try to take a deep breath and just be yourself and move through it. And then be thoughtful in your answers to their questions. So it's okay to take a second and think about the question. You don't have to, like, start immediately. You know, you don't want to sit there for, like, a minute and not say anything, but you can say, you know, I'm thinking about that for a second, and then start your answer. So try to be thoughtful in how you respond to their questions and be polite in your manner. And then what to do after an interview. It's a good practice to send a thank you note after an interview. And kind of along the lines of what Rebecca was talking about, it can be emailed or handwritten. I do think handwritten, they remember you better. Like a personal touch, but it can be harder to get that done and get that to them in time. So kind of just think about what, like if they say they're going to decide on the position by the end of the week, you might not want to mail a letter because they may not get it before they decide. I've heard of people having like a box of thank you notes in their car, and after the interview, like writing a note and then taking it back inside to the front desk person. So you can be creative like that too as well. And basically, you want them to remember you favorably. Even if you don't get the position, they may later think of you and remember, you know, that person seemed like it could be a good fit here or somewhere else. Or maybe that person doesn't work out and they contact you because they remember that you were also a good candidate. So you want them to remember you. They may pass on your resume in one of their contacts. You never know how that might happen. And then thinking about interviewing as an opportunity for growth. So, of course, you want it to be a place where you get a job. But if it doesn't work out, you can reevaluate and think, what could I have done better? What worked? What didn't work? And be better the next time. And you're also, in an interview, I know it's a tight job market, but you're also deciding, does this seem like somewhere where I want to work? You know, if you felt like you were interviewing with some people and it felt like it wasn't going to be a good match, that's also good for you to know ahead of time. So oftentimes they give you a chance at the end of the interview to ask questions about their company, to ask questions that you have. So that's a good time to ask some things that you're wondering about. But you're not going to want to ask things like about pay and things that are going to put them off. Because you'll find out about when they offer you the job, then they'll tell you about pay benefits and all of that. Or maybe it's on the job description. But when they ask you if you have any questions, you want to ask things like, you know, what's it like to work in this? What's the culture of this company? What's a typical project I might work on? Generally,
I've had interviews where, you know, they come up and they say, well, what kind of salary are you looking for? It's like, well, I really don't want to talk about this right now, but at the same time, I really don't want to go through this whole interview and make a big deal out of it and find out it's a minimum wage job. And it's kind of like, well, about anyway, so.
Right, so you've had interviewers that have asked you that?
Several.
Really?
Right, straight out, yeah, it just kind of, you know.
Yeah, that's harder because then you have more room for negotiation when they offer you the job, but when it's an interview.
Yeah.
It's difficult to know how to answer that.
However, they're trying to feel you out because it's neck and neck between two people, they'll take the person who's expecting less.
Huh, okay.
That's what I've heard, that they keep their cards closer to their chest when it comes to salary because they're trying to.
Right.